Sounds like Richard's gonna need a helping hand. Sorry, we got this full-blown survivalist fellow living out here all year round. Richard Hope. He got in a bit of trouble, it seems. I can fill you in on the details later. Careful. The underbrush can be a bit noisy this time of year. If an animal hears you approaching, you better believe it'll turn tail and run. Or worse. Thank you. White-tailed deer are often slightly bigger than the blacktail, but they're quicker to flee if they sense danger. noticed you're after moose. Tough animals, I tell ya. Be sure to bring the right caliber weapon to bring them down. Oh, and while their eyesight ain't too good, their smell is. So keep your scent and the wind in mind. Place, right? You won't find a soft bed in many parts around here. Don't forget to stock up before heading out. Mentioned earlier, Hope? Well, looks like he's been having a bit of a problem lately. He's been camping out over at Balmont a couple weeks, but coming back last night, he found his camp turned on its head. Some food was taken, and apparently the place looked like it had been really messed with. I don't know if it was an animal or some tourist troublemakers, but I'm up in Topeka all day and can't look into it. Listen, I know you probably have other plans, but you're in the right neck of the woods, and I'd sure be grateful if you could just stop on by and have a look. Hope showed up here 2 years ago. Said something about getting off the grid. I heard he lost his family in an accident while he was deployed overseas in the army. Hit the poor guy hard. I guess out here you only need to look out for yourself. It's easier that way. Not the most cheerful fella, to be honest, but he's earned his peace for sure. Let's find out whoever did this. some pictures for the record and see if they lead anywhere. Looks like a troublemaker then. Now, I don't want you to go picking any fights, but maybe you could follow them and see where they lead.
Oh!
ripped clothing. And no more tracks, huh? Well, just leave it for now, and I'll see what I can come up with. This'll help, though. Thanks. Black-tailed deer are one of the easiest animals in the reserve to hunt. Still, be wary of your noise and the wind direction, as their senses are quite good. Roosevelt elk, I see. The Roosevelt's a big fella, but its good sense of smell and hearing make it tricky to hunt. Thank you. are they unpredictable, but they also make very little sound and leave few tracks. You can sneak up on one without realizing it. Fortunately, they'll probably notice you before you them and will keep their distance. Still looking into that incident at Hope's camp. I spoke with him and he wanted me to pass on his thanks. He's been having some problems finding food lately though. The black-tailed deer are surprisingly scarce in Valmont for this time of year. Now Hope seems to think some black bears are passing through and scaring off the blacktails. Could be true, but it's hard to know for sure. If you come by any bear tracks in Valmont, let me know. these are some strong gusts today. I'll have to speak up, or you won't hear me. Blacktails are Hope's bread and butter. If you ever want hunting tips on him, he's your man. He's been with the Blacktails for a while now. If they're on the move, it's not only a problem for Hope. It might mean worrying changes for other parts of the reserve.